यस स्टूडेंट, नेक्स्ट वन इज कोएगुलेशन और टॉक्सुलेशन और प्रेसिपिटेशन। दिस थ्री टर्म आर यूज्ड फॉर द सेम थिंग। एक्चुअली व्हाट स्टूडेंट, एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन अर्लियर टू वीडियोस दैट द कोलाइड्स आर हैविंग आइदर पॉजिटिवली चार्ज और नेगेटिवली चार्ज। गेटिंग? वी हैव ऑल्सो सीन दैट इट इज नेसेसरी टू रिमूव एक्सेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलाइट which is responsible for the precipitation. Okay, student, we know that for collide we have to add a small amount of electrolyte, that is its quantity must be controlled. If its quantity is not controlled, that is it is excessive, then there is need to purification of the collide, which we have done by the dialysis method or ultrafiltration method. Getting? Now, if what will happen if the quantity of electrolyte added is high, then what? These added electrolyte will have positive and negative charge. So these positive or negative charge given by the added electrolyte can neutralize the charge present on the collide. That means what? That means the neutralization reaction means the precipitation will take place, and due to this precipitation the colloidal particle will settle down. Okay, this settling down of colloidal particle is known as coagulation. Student, you know about the blood coagulation. What is the blood coagulation? Actually what, when we got any of the injury in our skin or any of the body part, okay, then what happens? The blood is start to eliminate, remove from it, getting releasing from it. But after some time, if the injury is not so big injury or fatal injury, then the blood releasing automatically and spontaneously stops. What is the reason of it? The reason of it, the blood also consists electrolyte, and this electrolyte now the blood is considered as colloid. So these colloid interact with electrolyte, and thus the coagulation, that is the precipitation, takes place. This precipitated part deposited over the fatal or injured area, and thus now the further releasing of blood becomes stopped. This is called blood coagulation. Here it is also the same phenomenon. What? Simply the precipitation of collide by adding excess quantity of electrolyte is known as coagulation, or also called precipitation or called flocculation. The ion responsible for coagulation is called coagulating ion or flocculating ion, which is given by the added electrolyte. Now the Hardy-Schulze law. The Hardy-Schulze law, as we have seen, the quantity of the electrolyte which is required to coagulate a definite amount of colloidal solution, okay, not only depends on its quantity, but it also depends on the valency of the flocculating ion. That is, quantity is required, it is okay, but also it depends on the valency of the coagulating ion. As higher the valency of coagulating ion, greater will be the strength or power of coagulation of colloidal particle. Getting? On the basis of it, if we have to coagulate the negatively charged sole, example arsenic sulfide, then which type of electrolyte will be most sufficient? So one which is having highest positive charge, like the Na consists of one charge, so it has less power of coagulation. Mg has consists two charge, so little more charge. But Al consists three charge, so it has most power. Similarly, if we have to coagulate ferric hydroxide sole, which is positively charged, then we can select the most efficient, that is most highest valency having hexacyanoferrate, because it is having the 4- charge. while the PR consists only one charge, so its power of coagulation is very very low. That's it. Your surface chemistry chapter is now completed.